I welcome to all of you on the platform of this wire in the TeachNet journey, and let's start our session, let's start our journey. But before the journey, take a positive quote, as we always see some positive points, and our today's quote says that one small positive thought can change your whole day. Yes, so for the every day, one positive thought can change your whole day, and similarly that can change your whole life too. Okay, so be positive, be patient, be happy. Okay, so let's start. So what will be our agenda as we are completing our last three sessions now, right? We are completing the calendar topic. So this is the last type of the calendar actually, type three. After that there will be the revision. So before in this calendar, in this session today, we will first see the recap of the first lectures, what we have seen. After that, we will go for the type 3, which is a repetition of the calendar. On that, we will see the basics of that type 3, then how to solve that questions. Then questions on that type 3, then practice questions will be there for you. Of course, after that, there are some mixed type of questions I have taken actually for you. There are mixed type means, yes, the questions are also important. Some important questions I have picked up from the previous papers or important relevant. So these questions we will cover that, and then there will be the practice questions finally all done. And at the end, there will be double practice session. Okay, only mixed type of questions also and only type 3 also, and at the end, there will be summary. This is the total session. This is the total agenda of our sessions. Okay, so let's start. So in the recap, as we have seen the calendars type 1 and type 2, in the type 1, any one day is given and you have to calculate the another day, the day of that day with respect to take that day. Means, suppose they have given like today is a 6th July, so 6th July is a Tuesday, then what will be the day on the 17th November? What will be the day on the 2024 of the same day? These type of questions where one day is given and then you have to find another day. That was the type 1 questions which we were solved by the using odd days concept. By the odd day concept, you can solve it easily. Okay. After that, in the type 2 questions, we have seen that nothing has given and you just directly have to calculate any day, whatever they have given. Any year, any month, any day, just have to calculate that. For this, what we have done, we have divided that day in the first century leap year, nearest century leap year, then how many years are there in that year, how many ordinary year and leap year, then the number of months before that, whatever day is given, so number of months, how many months are there, then odd days of that month, and of course that date of whatever they have asked. Right, we have converted them all and we have calculated all the odd days, and by the after whatever the odd day, we have seen that one is for Monday. If 4 days are one, it's one for the Monday. Similarly, 2 for Tuesday, 3 for Wednesday, 4 for Thursday, and that's all. Like these questions, we have already seen these two types of questions, basics also. And now in this session, we are going to see the type 3 questions, which is of the repetition of the calendar. इसके क्वेश्चन आपको टीचनेट में मिलेंगे या देर आर टीचनेट पेपर इन 2021-2019. This type is really important as they have asked this type of questions. Okay, so let's concentrate. This is also easy, but you have to remember only some short things. If you remember it, then you can easily solve. Okay, you can solve orally too. Okay, so let's start. So first thing we will see that for the repetition of the leap year and repetition of the ordinary year. So first see for the repetition of the leap year, as it is easy, okay? Repetition of the leap year. So remember one thing is that repetition of leap year means what? Suppose if today, that means in the leap year, if not today, suppose there is any leap year, And on that leap year, suppose in a day, that means we can say that 5th July 2020. Okay, this is a leap year. I'm just considering this only for you. Okay, 5th July 2020. That means, and on that 5th July, let's suppose that there was a Saturday. Okay, I'm just supposing this. I don't know the example. So repeating means what? कि ऐसा कितने साल के बाद ऐसा आएगा कि exactly on that leap year that this 5 July same that 5 July 2000 something okay will be on the exactly on the Saturday. Repetition means what? That means 1st January. If my 1st January starting from the Monday and 31st that all days whatever we say that all calendar repeats itself. Nothing has changed. As everywhere, every year, as I said, if the 1st Jan in this 2 year, if it was on the Tuesday, then 2022, it will be on the Wednesday. That means all calendar is changed. So after how many years that all calendar completely match with each another? Also 2 years. After how many years there will be calendar which will be exactly matched with this year? It's called as a repetition. Okay. So what is the basic most important thing is that every leap year repeats on leap year itself. As in the leap year, there is a 29th day. That means one day is extra. So of course that one day is extra. So it cannot be repeat on any ordinary year. Of course, because there is no 29th day. That means one day all the calendar year changes by this one day. So first thing you have to remember is that. First thing you have to remember in this that this leap year repeats on leap year itself. Okay, leap year kabhi bhi ordinary years pe repeat nahi hota. Leap year repeats on leap year only. It's not possible that leap year repeat will on the ordinary. Okay, first point. This is the most important point. Then the second important point is that leap year repeats after 28 years. After every 28 years, that means जो भी 29th Feb 2020 को जिसका बर्थ था on the 29th Feb 2020 that was the Saturday. That means after how many years exactly on his birthday there will be the Saturday. That means अबे मुझे ऐसा year चाहिए जहाँ पे 29th Feb को फिर से Saturday आएगा. Of course in 2024 there will be 29th Feb but it won't be on the Saturday. So of course exactly on the Saturday for that the leap year repeats after the 28 years. These are the theoretical things actually. Yeah, there are some exceptional cases. Okay, so you just have to remember as this is theoretical thing. So leap year repeats after every 28 years, but yes, there is some exceptional cases. Okay, so as I said for the 2020 calendar, it will be repeat after 28 years. That means 2048. Okay, this will be repeat. Miss Rohan's birthday was on 29th 2020 Saturday. So again, he has to wait for the 2048 to celebrate his birthday on the Saturday. Okay, is this clear up to this? I'm gonna tell you the exceptional cases. But up to this, can you remember this? Leap year repeats after 28. That's it. Okay. Why 28 years actually? It's not like why 28 years. If you calculate that for the explanation, you have to go from 2020 to again it only 20 for to up to the 2048. You have to check whether it is coming or not. Okay, just like suppose in the 2020 something day 29th Feb or any day, suppose it was on the 2020, it won't come observed or not necessary 29th day, any another day also. Okay, it's not necessary on the 29th day, any another day also, but you have to calculate for whether in 2021 it will come up. If it was a Saturday in 2020, on whatever day, in 2021 there will be Sunday, 22 Monday, okay? If I say in 2020, it is a Saturday, for 2021 it will be Sunday, 22 Monday, 23 Tuesday, 24 as this is the leap year, so it will be instead of Tuesday, it will be on Wednesday and Thursday. Similarly, Friday, Saturday, so it won't come on the Saturday because, as I said, it is of 29th day, right? I'm talking about the 29th day, actually. It won't be there. Okay, as we want a leap year. So after that, 25 and 26, right? So in 2026, it will be the Friday. But as 2026 is not a leap year, that means that day will not be come here. If you observe that, actually you won't understand by this, but this is not important. No one asked you that. You just have to remember this thing actually. Or for that, we have to go from 2020 to 2048. We have to check the calendars whether it is repeating or not. And it's too much length, okay, which is really not necessary. So as I said, it is not a leap year 2026, so it won't be on the Saturday. That day, 2025 won't be on the Saturday. So what I said now, yeah. So the leap year repeats after the 28 years, okay? Is 28 year thing true for ordinary year? So no. As I said, I am talking about only for leap year, and there are also some exceptional cases. So whatever, please listen whatever I am saying, okay? For ordinary, we will see another thing. This is only for leap year and only for this thing, okay? So after this, as I said, but there are some exceptional cases for this. Okay, let's see first for the leap year. After that, we will go for the ordinary year. First, clear the concept of leap year itself. Okay, then what is the exceptional case day? Just like as I said, if it was a 1872 and it has to repeat after the 28 years, right? So if I said 1872 plus 28, what will be the year? 1900. But as I know that 1900 is not a leap year, so is it possible? Because as I know that leap year repeats after on every leap year itself. Leap year repeats on leap year itself. So it's not possible that 1872 will be repeat on the 1900. So instead of 20 years, at that time, exceptional cases says that this leap year repeats after 40 years. Okay, 40 years. Only two conditions are there. Okay, so in this type, whatever you have to remember, that only two things, that first thing, leap year repeats after the 20 years. But if there is a century, ordinary year in between them, century, ordinary year, because this is not a leap year. If it's coming on the century or year, that means at that year, it won't be 28 years. At that time, it will be 40 years. Okay, only two things. So leap year repeats after every 28 or 40 years. Either 28 or 40 years, only 2 years. For the leap year repetition, either 28 or 40. As it's always 28, only for the 40, whenever there is this type of year, which is a century, ordinary year there, then it will be repeat after the 40 years. Otherwise, it will be repeat after the 28 years. Okay? As if I said in 2018, right, okay? Suppose in 2018. As if I said after 28, there is a 2108. But in there is a 2100, which is a century leap year, century ordinary years. At that time also, instead of 28, I will add 40, and that means it will be repeat only 2 or 2. It's not necessary that that plus 28 should be the 1900. So if it is up to always 120, then also it will become as a. Actually, there are too many exceptional cases also. For this also, there is another exceptional case actually. But as they don't ask for the this level, as they won't ask, it won't be the 2120 actually. It will be of another something. It will be around, I think, minus 20. No, yeah, minus 20, it's come down, right? So it will be 2120. As there are some exceptional cases, but they never asked because it's too much. Abhi to pucha hi nahi then. Okay, there are too much exceptional cases whenever in every, whatever, any time it comes on another, but otherwise means surplus 99.9999%, that means all times it's either 28 or 40. So have you understood that when 28 and when 40? So 1912. What are you talking about 1912? Yeah, so this is a 19th version, right? So as I have to add for 40 years, because this 1900 is not possible, that means 1872 plus 40, that means it will be on the 19th version. Okay, clear? So we will have to remember century ordinary years. Now let's see for the ordinary year, then we will go for the question, okay? As per for the leap year, similarly for the ordinary year, it repeats on the ordinary year itself. Okay. Repeats after ordinary year. It is not possible that ordinary year will repeat on the leap year. Because in the leap year, there is a 29th day which is added, so all dates get changed. So ordinary year repeats on the ordinary year itself. But ordinary year repeats after either 6 or 11 years. 6 or 11 years. Okay, for the ordinary year, there is either 6 or 11 years. So let's see the example, let's see the concept. Whenever we use the conditions, whenever we take the 6 year or whenever we take the 11 years. Okay, so what we do that, for the just whatever the year is given, okay, whatever given year they have given, we just divide them by 4, that year by 4. So if the remainder, okay, if the remainder is a 1, if you read on the slide that condition 1 remainder is a 1, that means that calendar will repeat after the 6 year. Like example 2021, okay, first thing 2021, divide this by 4, last 2 digit only, okay, so this 21 by 4, what will be the remainder? Remainder is a 1. Whenever the remainder is 1, that means calendar will repeat after the 6 years. Whenever the remainder is a 1, that means calendar will repeat after the 6 years. And the another condition is that if the remainder is a 2, for 2021 it is a 6 year, for the 2022, 22 by 4, remainder is a 2. Whenever the remainder is a 2 or 3, that means it will repeat after the 11 years. That's it. If the remainder is 1, 6 years. Remainder is 2 or 3, 11 years. That's it. For the 2005, this is the ordinary year. Divide by this 4. What will be the remainder? Remainder is 1. Whenever remainder is a 1, repeats after 6 years. That means 2005 plus 6, it will be 2011. That's it. Okay, let's see for the next question, and this is really easy. This is the question which is of the T-SNET 2021. The leap day falls on the same day of the week after a gap of, that is leap year. Leap year kitne years ke baad repeat hota hai? 28 years. By the option 5, 7, 11 is not possible. That means your answer will be 20. Okay. Again, next question is a question of T-SNET 2019, that means just 19 by 4, remainder is a 3. So whenever remainder is a 3, repeats after 11 years. These are the questions of the T-SNET exam. So yes, this type of questions will be there. And these are really easiest type of question, calendar repetition is also, but you have to remember those two things only, okay? Now the calendar for the year 1988 is same as which upcoming year? So 1988 plus 28 is a 2016. As yes, there is one century year which is a 2000, but as this is a leap year, so of course there will be 28 years. That means your answer will be 2016. Question number 5. As I know that from 2076, first what will I do? I will try to add the 28, right? After this 28, what is the answer? 2104, right? After 28. But in this 2076 to 2104, there is a one century year which is a 2100. Is this is a leap year? Because I am calculating for the leap year. And this 28 concept is only for the leap year, right? So of course, there should be the leap year. If it is it a leap year? No, that means go for the 40 years. So 2076 plus 40 will be 2116. So the answer will be 2116. So there are some questions that remain in this topic. So let's take all those questions also. Okay, so that in the next lecture we can take the revision of that. So there are some mixed type of questions actually. So the first question is again a T-SLET 2018. Miss, whatever day was on the 4, that 4 after that it will be repeated after 7 years, that is on 11, again 19 and then for 26. That means 4 and 24 is not possible, first option. Similarly, second also, 6 and 30, 6 plus 7, 13. Okay, 30, right. 13 plus 7 it is a 20, 20 plus 7 is a 27, and of course 27 plus that means it will be the next week, next month, so it is also not possible. For the third, as I have this in the 13, then 20, then 27, of course this will become on the same day. When you don't need to solve all these also, you can see by the difference also, that's really easy. Let's add 777 in there, in that whatever they are coming in the same line, that days will lie on the same day. So let's go for the next question now. If it was a first Monday on 1st Jan 2018, then what is the weekday on the 31st December 2018? As it is an ordinary year, that means that year starts and ends on the same day. Ordinary year starts and ends on the same day. So of course, it will be the Monday. Okay, let's go for the another question also. There are some questions, this type of questions. In the 10 November 2018 is a Saturday, then what will be the 10 November 2017? 10 November 2018 was a Saturday. What will be 10 November 2017? Of course, as I am going 1 year back and there is no any leap year, right? That means it's ordinary year, normal. So, of course, 1 day back, that means only minus 1, as it is a minus 1, Saturday minus 1, it will be Friday. So, on the 10th November 2017, it will be Friday. Now, I have to come from 10 November 2017 to, what are they, 15th August 2017, right? So, let's come from August to November. As instead of going back, go from August to November. So from 15 August, that means how many days from the August are remain? August is of 31 days and already 15 August is completed. That means there will be 16 days of August plus September. September either take 30 or take the odd year. In the September, there will be two odd days. August, September, October, 3 odd days. And for the November, how many days there are? 10 days. So as 10 plus 13 plus 15, 15 plus 16 is a 31, 31 by 7, it is a remainder will be 3, right? So as I am going by the backwards, I have to subtract 3. So Friday minus 3 will be Thursday, Wednesday and Tuesday. So your answer will be Tuesday. Is it clear to all? Next question is again of same time almost. What are they saying that Mithu's birthday is on Wednesday, 8th March. On what day of the week will be Ritu's birthday in the same year if Ritu was born on the 10th July? That means they have given that 8th March is a Wednesday. Find out 10th July birthday. 8th March to 10th July. Now March to July. In the March, it is of 31 days month and already 8 days are completed. That means how many days are remain? 23. So March to 23 level. April, 30 days month, that means 2 odd days. May, 31 days month, that means 3. In the June, 30 days means 2. In the July, I have to take for the 10 days. Now let's add. As I can take, okay, 23 plus 2, 25 plus this 5, 30 plus 10, 40. 40 by 7, it is a 7, 5 is a 35, that means 5 is a remainder, right? So 5 remainder means it was a Wednesday. So Wednesday plus 5. Wednesday plus 5 is for Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday. So your answer will be Monday. So let's go for the next question. Okay. As what are they saying that Akash remembers that it matches after 26th April but before 30th April. After 26th, that means I won't consider the 26th because after 26th. After 26 and before 38, that means of course I won't consider these two dates, but in between what are the dates? 27, 28 or 29, okay? It might be on 27, might be on 28 or 29. But yes, as you know that after 26 and before 30. Now, while Suresh remembers that match is after 22 but before 28. After 22 and before 28. That means I would consider this today. But after 22, that means it might be 23, 24, 25, 26, 27. Right? As they both are right. So what is the date matching in both days? 27. Because of course, as per his cast sentence, of course it won't be up to 23 to 26. Because he's saying after 26. And as per after this, it's not after the 28. That means 20 is also not possible. So 29 is also not possible. That means only one day is possible. It's the 27. So that's all for today. Thank you so much for putting your efforts, for your time. Thanks a lot. I hope you understood all. So let's up to that. Bye bye. Take care.